Hello everyone. Today I discuss about numerical taxonomy. Although this part is a vast area of taxonomic part, so let's come to the discussion. First of all, I want to discuss about the taxonomy in briefly. We know that taxonomy, that means, comes from the taxis and nomos, that is the arrangement of living organism based on specific rules or some principles. This is known as taxonomy, and taxonomy is a scientific study of the organisms, which deals with identification of the species, nomenclature of the species, and categorization, that is classification of species, and also formation or documentation of these species. And this term, that is taxonomy, was first introduced. The term was introduced by the botanist Augustine Pyramus de Candolle, or we know that A.P. de Candolle, in 1813. Rather than the father of taxonomy is known as Carolus Linnaeus. So there are three different category or components of the taxonomy. One is identification, nomenclature, and classification. As well as for the further reference use, the documentation is very important for the taxonomy. Let's I discuss about the three different terms. One is phenetic, cladistic, and chronistic. Phenetic. Phenetic, that means, comes from the phenology, and this term based on the overall similarity. And cladistic, based on the common line of descendants, that is evolutionary significance. Here the evolutionary significance you can find. Next, chronistic, temporal relation among various evolutionary branches. This is also related to the evolutionary significance. Let's come to our main discussion topic, numerical taxonomy. So I discuss about the taxonomy in brief, and here another term is numerical taxonomy. There are so many categorization of taxonomy, like chemical taxonomy, genetic taxonomy, phenetic taxonomy, cytological taxonomy, pollen biological taxonomy, and this is also a branch, or this is also a categorization of taxonomy, that is numerical taxonomy. And this taxonomy very important, because we can include so many characteristics, or we can gather so many characteristics for the classification or categorization of plants. So the numerical taxonomy can be defined as the numerical evolution of the similarity between groups of organisms and the ordering of these groups into higher ranking taxa on the basis of these similarities. Although we talk about the similarity, but in case of numerical taxonomy, we can take several characteristics for the categorization or the evaluation. You can use your desirable character, what you want to what you want the characters you can use for the evolution of two different groups or organisms. That's why no confinement of characteristics is limited in the numerical taxonomy. And this numerical taxonomy in present day, the frequency of use, that means this type of taxonomy is frequently used in the field, biological field, and this numerical taxonomy, you can apply the mathematical procedure in the numerical taxonomy. That's why this is a vast area for the classification or for the taxonomic area. And scientist Peter H. A. Hipp and et al., they defined that numerical taxonomy is a system of grouping of species by numerical methods based on their character states. So you can use your desirable character. You want to include so many characters, so you can include the characteristics for this numerical taxonomy. That's why the organisms can be ordered, can be grouped, can be categorized based on the different character or characteristic states. Next, come to the character representation. How can we represent the character in numerical taxonomy? The method of character representation always represented by the two states, one is zero and another one is one. Zero states for the absence of particular character and one states for the presence of particular character. That means if we see that 1 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 0, that means the one signifies that the A taxa have this character, B taxa have, C taxa has here, but this has no character. And if we see the seventh character, A has no seventh character, B has no seventh character, but D has this character. So we can represent the character based on one and zero. So this is very much interesting and is very much accessible based on the zero and one number. And this method is known as pairing affinity or PA. So pairing affinity can be calculated by the following formula. Bands common to species A and B, or character common to species A and B, and total character in A and B into 100. So you can use so many characters, 10, 15, 100, 1000, 2000, as you like. So what you have to classify, or you have to design or denote one and zero, that is which one common and which one not common. And we can use one for the presence and zero for the absence. That's why PA is equal to characters common to species A and B by total number of characters in A and B into 100. So this is the characteristic representation method or implementation method of numerical taxonomy. Next, come to the aspect of numerical taxonomy. Why we have to use numerical taxonomy? What is the aspect? There are mainly two different aspects: construction of taxonomy group and discrimination of taxonomy group. If you want to construct a taxonomy group, you can use numerical taxonomy. Whereas if you want to discriminate the taxonomy group, then you can also use the numerical taxonomy. So let's come to the what is construction of taxonomy group. Construction means all of you know about the construction. So construction, if we want to construct a taxonomy group, then large number of characteristics can be approached in numerical taxonomy. Then you can find the resemblance or similarity and dissimilarity among the individuals are then established on the basis of character analysis based on the one and zero. And after that, after the calculation, that means pairing affinity, you can construct a taxonomy group based on the numerical taxonomy. And there is most advantageous that you can use large number of characters. What you want to approach? You want to, if you want to include this character, if you want to include leaf character, stem character, root character, or intermediate character, vascular bundle character, etc., etc., anatomical, morphological, cytological, evolutionary. So many characters you can use for the construction of taxonomic group by the numerical taxonomy. And another one is the discrimination of taxonomic group. If you want to discriminate, if you want to know that, or if you see that some character becomes overlapping with each other, so for this purpose you can use the discrimination character, you can use the discrimination, and after discrimination you can find a taxonomic group. This is known as the discrimination of taxonomic group. So when the taxonomic groups chosen for the study how overlapping of characters, so discrimination should be used for this. So there are two different aspects: construction and discrimination. Okay, let's come to the principle of taxonomic group. What are the principles? Every process, every method have some principles. So numerical taxonomy is not an exceptional. So there are so many principles. I discuss about the 7 different principles for the numerical taxonomy. You can gather more content of information. That means you can gather large number of character for the construction or for the analysis or for the implementation of numerical taxonomy. That means more the characters you can consider for this taxonomy. Here, each and everyone can give equal weightage in creating new taxa or construction of new taxa. That means each and every character have the equal weightage. No character left. That means no character cannot give extra weightage to a specific character. Here each and every character get the equal weightage. Next, in case of numerical taxonomy, the function of individual similarities in each of many characters. Because as we implemented 0 and 1 in this case, so each and every entity function of individual of similarity in each of the many characters. Next is the correlation of character differs in the group of organisms under study. Here the correlation of character differs, thus distinct taxa can be recognized. You can easily recognize the distinct taxa because you try to find out correlate, or you try to correlate between two taxa depending on the large number of character. That's why you can recognize the different group or distinct group. Phylogenetic conclusion can be drawn from the taxonomic structure because here you use morphological character, you use phenetic character, you use phylogenetic character, evolutionary character, cytological character, each and every character you can use. That's why you can form a phylogenetic line by that numerical taxonomy. Here the mathematical formula can be used in the numerical taxonomy. You can use the mathematical formula. In case of numerical taxonomy, the phenetic similarity is the base of classification. Here you can use so many phenetic character or phylogenetic character cytological character rather than you can use more and more morphological, that means phenetic character. Next is the advantages of the numerical taxonomy. The advantage mainly, this is the conventional taxonomy and improved by the numerical taxonomy, and it utilizes better and more number of characters. This one is the most advantage. Each and every character, you can include large number of characters in this method. Next one. Nowadays, the numerical methods are more sensitive in delimiting taxa. The data obtained can be efficiently used in the construction of better key, because suppose you think that this character is not significant for the construction of taxonomic group. But when you use in numerical taxonomy, it shows that it has a better significant in the construction of taxonomic group. That's why the numerical taxonomy plays an important role in the classification system. Nowadays, the biological concept have been interrupted by the numerical taxonomy, because so many biological concept developed based on some criteria, based on some specific character. But nowadays, the numerical taxonomy changes or interrupted these concept. This one is a very important enlightenment or improvement in our taxonomic field. Next, numerical taxonomy allows more taxonomic work to be done by less highly skilled worker. Because if you think that a characteristics or a classification based on 5 or 6 character, if this character segregation of this character or identifying or knowing this character is a skill based work, then so many people cannot do it. But in case of numerical taxonomy, so many low skilled worker can done some work in the numerical taxonomy as well as taxonomic field. So these are the advantages. And if you think that no disadvantage in numerical taxonomy, not some disadvantage also occurred in case of numerical taxonomy. So let's come to that. First one, numerical methods are useful in phenetic classification and not phylogenetic classification, because here large number of characteristics are gathered. That means phenetic, genetic, phylogenetic, all the characters are included here. So if you confined in the phylogenetic character, then it is phylogenetic classification. The proponents of biological species concept may not accept this specific limit, because we know that biological species concept depends on the reproductive character or reproduction of the biological system. Next is the character selection is the greatest disadvantage in this approach. How can you select the character? What are the basis of selection, of your selection? So this is some limitation. Different taxonomic procedure may yield different results. If I include 5 characters, this is a different result. If you include more than 5 characters, then another result is found. If you use more than 100 characters, you can found another result. So results become vary from one to another. These are the disadvantages. Next, come to the application. There are so many application in case of taxonomic field, but I just describe or three application. The numerical taxonomy is used in various angiospermic genera like Apocynum, Chenopodium, Crotalaria, Cucurbita, etc., etc. With the help of numerical taxonomy, similarity and differences in bacteria, other or microorganisms can be studied. Phytochemical data from seed protein and mitochondrial DNA RFLP study has been numerically analyzed to study the interspecific variation. So these are the basic application of numerical taxonomy. If you if we find in case of plant system, so then we found out so many application in the taxonomic field. So thank you. If you have any question, then you can put in the comment box. Thank you.